Hi, I'm Dr. Sinderpal Singh and I teach Indian Ocean Security at the Rajaratnam School of International Studies. When it comes to Indian Ocean Security, there are two parts about Indian Ocean Security we need to discuss. The what and the why. What is the Indian Ocean? The Indian Ocean is the third largest ocean on Earth. It covers 20% of the water surface on Earth. The Indian Ocean is also home to several strategic seas, bays and gulfs. A few examples: the Red Sea, the Straits of Hormuz, the Malacca and Sunda Straits, and the Gulf of Aden. These are just few of the strategic bays and seas within the Indian Ocean. The Indian Ocean is also home to a large range of littoral states, stretching from Africa, the Middle East, Asia, and Australia. The Indian Ocean is also home to different types of states. We have your standard sovereign states, but you also have dependencies of the United Kingdom and France within the Indian Ocean. Now, why study the Indian Ocean? In 2009, Robert Kaplan wrote an article in Foreign Affairs talking about the Indian Ocean being the center stage for global politics in the 21st century. Why did Robert Kaplan say this? For two reasons. The first is the Indian Ocean is the space where two-thirds of the world's petroleum supplies travel through. This makes the security of energy supplies a key theme within Indian Ocean security. The second reason why Robert Kaplan says the Indian Ocean is the center stage of global politics in the future is it is the site of competition between India and China in determining the future complexion of global politics. When India and China come together in the Indian Ocean, their relationship with each other will determine how global politics will be shaped in the 21st century. Besides great power competition and state-to-state competition, the Indian Ocean is also the site of various other types of issues and themes which are very pertinent to global politics in our time. For example, piracy, global warming, maritime terrorism.